Precision air conditioners are just like the normal ACs we use. Both work on the refrigerant cycle concept. So, in both units, you will find an evaporator, compressor, expansion valve, and condenser. The AC we normally use is called a comfort AC. This AC helps us maintain a comfortable temperature and humidity level. However, it may not be as precise in maintaining the exact temperature and humidity. But a precision air conditioner can maintain much more precise temperature and humidity. And the normal AC we use runs for about 6 to 8 hours a day. However, PACs are designed to run 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. In most cases, at least 3 PACs are used in a single location. Every 6 to 8 hours, each PAC automatically switches over and takes over the operation. If there is a problem with one PAC, the next PAC automatically starts running. This ensures that the unit remains in continuous operation. PACs are used in places with very sensitive and expensive equipment, such as data centers, server rooms, laboratories, and telecommunication rooms. In these environments, it's crucial to maintain extremely accurate temperature and humidity levels. Let's take data centers as an example. A data center is like the brain of a company. All its data are stored here. Suppose a data center overheats, the performance of the equipment within it could slow down, and sometimes the whole data center might even shut down. The excess heat also increases the chances of damage to circuit boards and hard drives. Excessive humidity can lead to condensation, forming water droplets that might fall onto the electronic equipment, potentially causing damage. On the other hand, low humidity levels can increase static electricity, which can also damage sensitive equipment. These issues can result in significant financial losses for companies. According to estimates, data center-related issues cause billions of dollars in losses worldwide each year. To avoid these problems, data centers use PACs. Like a regular air conditioner, PAC also functions based on the refrigerant cycle concept. However, PAC enables accurate control of temperature and humidity and can produce high-quality air, and it can run continuously for 24 hours. It also has evaporator coil, evaporator fan motor, compressor, expansion valve, condenser coil, and condenser fan motor. We have uploaded a video on our channel explaining how the refrigerant cycle works. The link to the video is in the description. Those who are interested can watch it and learn more. In PACs, high-quality filters like HEPA filters are used. These filters can trap particles as small as 0.3 microns in size. This ensures that high-quality air is supplied to the data center. And the use of an inverter compressor and electronic expansion valve allows for very precise control of the room temperature. To maintain humidity levels, PACs use humidity sensors and a built-in humidifier. In a normal air conditioner, the supply and return ducts are both located at the top. However, in PAC, the return duct is located at the top and the supply duct is located at the bottom. In a data center, the heat generated by the equipment is expelled upwards through exhaust fans. This heat is then directly drawn into the PAC through the return duct. By supplying cool air from below, the equipment can be cooled directly and quickly. In PAC systems, if both the return and supply ducts are located at the top, there's a risk of condensation. The hot air from the equipment and the cold air from the supply duct can mix, leading to condensation and the formation of water droplets. These droplets can fall onto the equipment, potentially causing damage. Water leak sensors are installed at the bottom of the data center to detect any water leaks. If a leak is detected, an alarm will immediately notify us. In a data center, the air drawn into the PAC, through the return duct, first passes through a filter to remove dust and other contaminants. Next, the filtered air is directed through the evaporator coil, where it is cooled by the refrigerant circulating within the coil. An evaporator fan motor then drives the cooled air through the supply duct, delivering it back to the data center. This process of air filtration, cooling, and distribution is continuous, ensuring that the data center maintains a cool and controlled environment. To maintain the desired humidity level in a data center, PACs employ various mechanisms to adjust the moisture content of the air. When the humidity level drops below the desired range, the humidifier generates water vapor, which is then mixed with the air stream and distributed through the supply duct. This process increases the humidity level and brings it back to the target range. Conversely, when the humidity level exceeds the desired range, the evaporator coil, responsible for cooling the air, also plays a role in dehumidification. As the air passes over the cold coil, its temperature drops, causing water vapor in the air to condense and form water droplets. These droplets are then removed from the airstream, effectively reducing the humidity level. In some PAC units, additional components like heaters or dehumidifiers may be employed to further refine humidity control. Like the air conditioners we use at home, PACs also operate based on the refrigeration cycle concept. PACs are often referred to as precision air conditioners, while standard air conditioners are called comfort air conditioners. PACs are primarily employed in environments where precise temperature and humidity control are essential, such as data centers, server rooms. To achieve accurate temperature regulation, PACs often incorporate inverter compressors and electronic expansion valves. Humidity control in PACs are achieved through the use of humidifiers and dehumidifiers. PACs are designed for continuous operation, capable of running 24/7 throughout the year. PACs often employ high-quality filters, such as HEPA filters, to remove particles as small as 0.3 microns from the air. This is the explanation of the working principle of PACs. I hope this video has provided you with a clear understanding of how PACs operate. If you have any questions or doubts regarding the video's content, feel free to leave a comment below. If you found the video helpful and informative, please give it a thumbs up and share it with others who might benefit from it. Don't forget to subscribe to our Zebra Learnings channel for more educational and informative videos. Thank you for your support.